All right, whenever you guys are ready, you can go ahead.
Hi, members. I'm Tracy Narag, one of the trainers here. And this is...
I'm Ivona, one of the trainers too. Working the channel for a very long time. That's the second time we've been having some issue with the club being open, but welcome to our class.
We're going to try to keep you guys in shape. We're going to offer a little bit of an interval workout here. We're going to be using some light weights. We just have some fives that we're going to use. And we're going to do a little warm-up first. Then we're going to do a 30-second work rate, followed by a 15-second rest. I am using an interval timer for the first time, so please excuse it if there's any issues. And full disclosure, I am not a class instructor. Okay, so.
Tracy's going to show you a little bit harder version. I'm going to have more low impact, so anybody can use that class. As you wish, you can go a little bit higher, hyper, a little bit lower impact. Have fun.
Okay, we're going to start off with some jumping jacks. Ready?
Ready?
Do
go.
Low version. Go. Full arm swing. Get your arms all the way up there.
You
stay
soft. Step side to side. You can bend your knees a little bit.
You counting? I'm not counting.
I have nine.
Okay. Let's go five more. Four, three, two, one. Okay, let's go
very
into
good.
Squats. I'm going to have my hands on the back of my head. I'm going to get nice and low, full range of motion.
In front, so if you have an issue with your shoulders, it's a little bit easier. Try to go as deep as you can. But remember, it's still a warm up.
Loosening up my hips, loosening up my legs.
Breathe. Great job, Tracy.
It's a lot easier to count when clients are working out. Let's go four more. Three. Two. Okay, the next warm-up. Inchworm. You're going to do an inchworm. When you get out to your plank, you're going to step towards your hand, turn and raise your arm, alternating legs.
So do five of those.
Five.
Ready?
Go. Try to keep your legs as straight as you can on the way down. Step up, turn and look. Alternate. Walk it back up. Same thing. Try to keep your knees straight. Loosen up those legs. Here's one. Alternate, step up, get that foot flat. Try to get your leg, knee at 90 degrees. All the way up, two. All right, I'm tired and ready. Turn and look. Loosen up that body, get ready to work. All the way up, three. How you doing?
I'm great. One more to go.
All the way up. Four. Got one more. Step. Turn.
Excellent.
Okay. I'm going to get the interval ready. Grab some light weights. Like I said, we're using the fives. It's going to go in 10 seconds. We have a lunge. You're going to do a pulse lunge. I'm going to jump and switch. Ready? 30 seconds. Go. Pulse and down.
It's an easier version. You're going to have to jump. You have to pulse.
Drive through that front heel.
Yep. Nice form. Try to keep your knee behind the toe.
Get nice and low. You really work that butt. 10 seconds. Rest. 15 second rest. Bring your weights to the ground or get in a plank, renegade row, alternating sides.
I'm going to do the same version, but keep my knees bent, so this way it's a little bit easier.
Go. Body stays nice and tight. Use those abs, work in that core. Bring your arm close to the body, straight up.
Up, but keeping them down, up to you. But keep your hands up and under your shoulders, the most important. Keep your belly tight. Push that belly button into your spine.
3 seconds.
Great.
Okay, side shuffle and touch. No weight. Touch that outside hand towards your foot.
Go to the left, right?
To the left. 3 seconds. Fixing my watch.
Go. Something just a little step. A little bit easier. Tracy, you need to do big shuffle.
Excuse me. I'm gonna get in your face here.
It's all good. Try to bend those knees.
Ten seconds. Five seconds.
Great.
Next one, push up and turn.
Again, I'm going to do easier version. It's going to be on your knees.
Ready? Go.
Go.
Nice job, Ivona. Abs are nice and tight.
Yeah. That chest down to the floor. If you on your knees, to make it a little bit harder. You can do one more.
Last one.
Excellent.
Okay, bringing it to the floor. Gonna work some core, some abs. We're gonna start with Superman on your stomach.
Yep.
Arms extended out in front. Everything lifts and holds. Working that lower back.
If you have a hard time, you can drop your head and keep it lower. Squeeze your glutes.
Looking to the floor. 1 pound hold.
Squeeze your glutes. Breathe.
Nice. Okay, side plank, top leg lifts.
Again, I'm going to do easier version. I'm going to, my lower legs are going to be on the floor. Then my hands are going to be under the shoulder. But I'm still going to be able to do leg lifts. If you have a hard, still hard time, you can put your top hand right in the front for the stability. But remember here, you still want to work your core.
Make sure the elbows
stay up. It's great.
Make sure the elbows directly under your shoulder.
Yes.
10 seconds.
Again, then put your hand right in the front.
Switch sides.
Side.
Okay, elbow directly under your shoulder, holding those hips up, working those obliques, the core.
Go.
30 seconds.
Nice and tall.
It's quiet on this.
Welcome to Chatham Club Home Gym.
Halfway there. Alternating a knee to your chest. Okay, lie on your back. Arms are down to your sides.
Or you can move your arms wider so better stability.
Lift up the hips.
Up.
Hold on your
heels into your glutes. Slow glide.
You want to feel this in your glutes, not the hamstring. Keep your hips up nice and high. Slow, controlled lift. Bring the knee to your chest. Hands are pressing into the floor. That heel is pressing into the floor. Nice and tight for your abs. Fire up those glutes.
Fire up.
Okay, back up. Okay, lateral lunges. Grab your weight.
Easier version will be no weights. You can keep your hands in the front, kind of press them tight together so you can kind of create a little more isometric movement.
Staying on the same side. That was cheating, by the way. I saw that.
I was waiting for you.
Yeah.
So make sure your toes are pointing the same direction.
Drive your butt back.
Yep.
inner thigh, get into the glute.
Fire the glutes.
5 seconds.
Tracy, how many years I know you? For 20? At least?
At least.
Yeah.
I thought you were going to say, how many years you're firing your glutes? A long time.
Probably more than that.
5 seconds. Three,
try to have a slide.
Two,
I won't be cheating this
one.
Time.
Good. Bring that hip back. Sit back into it.
Yep.
Don't let that knee come out too far in front of
your
foot.
Feel it right there. Keep pressing your hands against each other. This way you really can create more of the upper body tension since we don't use any weights. If you if you have heavier weights at home, you can do so. Do whatever you prefer.
Okay.
Great job.
Thank you. You too. Sumo squats.
Love
I'm going to keep
sumo
the weights.
Squats. And I'm going to keep my hands.
And I'm going to add a little jump in there too.
Yes. So again, reverse cover.
One.
Go.
Upper body stays nice and straight.
Nice and tall.
Wherever your toes are, that's where your knees follow.
Yep. Get a little bit wider.
Maybe you can. I can't.
Make 5 seconds. Arms are tight. Great.
Okay, bring it to the floor. Bring your weights down. You can hold that bridge. We're gonna go for a chest fly and a pullover.
I'm gonna do the same version, but keep my hips grounded. It's a little bit easier.
Fly, hips up all the whole time. Hands together, arms straight, all the way over.
When you're on the floor and you make sure you press your lower back and then pull over because that's when your back tries to arch.
Keep resetting your hips if they drop. Glutes, you should be feeling those glutes burning. Chest, lats. Okay.
Great.
Okay, we're staying down here. Russian twist.
So I'm gonna actually do the harder version this time. So my feet are going to be up. And Tracy's feet are gonna be grounded. So that's two different versions.
Okay, here we go.
Ready? Go.
Side to side. Keep your back straight.
Hello.
Halfway there.
Make sure your back is nice and straight. You don't want to roll back.
Okay. Reach your toes.
Great. So you're going to do with the weight, I'm going without?
Sure.
Yeah, sure. All right. So you can keep your legs straight, like Tracy, or can cross them over like I'm going to do. And you can do it together, or you can do all today. Make sure that you're lifting your shoulder blades off the ground. Three at a time, looking up.
As high as you can reach, this is all I got.
I'm going to show you different ways you can do it. Pick whatever you like.
Okay, one more here. Crunch one leg up and down.
Great, you're doing with the weight, so I will do with the weight.
Go ahead.
All right. I would like this exercise. One of my favorite.
One leg extended, one leg bent.
Again, think about your shoulder blades. We're gonna lift them up. Tighten up your shin. Please don't hit yourself.
We'll switch at 15, okay?
Good.
Switch.
How many have?
Switch.
Great. So try not to rest your leg or your hands on the floor, but if you're really having a hard time, you can do so. Great job.
Okay, come on up. We're going to jump rope. We don't need to use a jump rope. We're just going to pretend.
So again, Tracy is going to do a little bit higher impact. I'm going to show you a little bit lower impact.
Go.
So basically, you just can lift your heels, use your hands for the imaginary jump rope.
Sorry, this way. Group.
This way you can still do some cardio. You can, you know, do a little bit circle with your hand. You can go backwards. It's up to you. Again, you can follow Tracy or you can follow me.
Both
legs are good.
You feel good, yeah.
Yeah, I can do that too.
Okay, right. Bringing it to the
Tracy.
Floor. Didn't know I had tricks, huh?
Yeah.
Mountain climbers.
All right, so
if you have paper plates, you can use these at home.
Again,
nothing really slides here, so
Tracy,
we're just going.
Tracy, do a little bit harder version. I'm going to show you the easier version. Get the hands under your shoulders. Stay the plank. Bring your knees up to the forward.
Not too much movement for your body.
Yeah.
Drive your knees to your chest.
Yes.
Halfway there. Eight seconds. Five.
Great.
Four. Here's a fun one. Got your weight on the floor. You're gonna do some burpees. Jumping over your weight.
So this is going to be, I'm gonna be facing this way. So I'm going to use the bench for the easier version.
Down to the floor if you want.
So you can use a chair. If you do, make sure the chair is against the wall. Great.
Awesome job, you guys.
You can repeat the same.
Good luck.
Good luck. You can
repeat.
Oh, all right. We have to wash our hands now.